Welcome to Basic Electrical Engineering, Unit 5, Lecture 13, on 20th of April 2020. Today's topic, probably the last topic of Unit 5, is circuit breakers. The rest of the topics in Unit 5 have already been discussed, and this is the only topic that is left for us to complete Unit 5. Circuit breaker. What is a circuit breaker? It is a switching device which can be operated manually and automatically for controlling and protection of electrical power system. During fault, high current will flow and there will be a damage to the equipment. So we need some devices to protect the equipment or the network from damage. A circuit breaker does all the switching operations, that is disconnecting the faulty section when there is a high current and then again connecting it when the fault has been isolated. It consists of fixed and movable contacts called electrodes. A circuit breaker generally has a fixed and a movable contacts. There are many types of circuit breakers. Almost everything will have the same structure like fixed and movable contacts called electrodes. What is the mechanism behind this? Under normal operating conditions, contacts remain closed. When fault occurs, trip coils of the breaker gets energized and moving coil is pulled apart, thus opening the circuit. This is what generally happens in any of the circuit breaker. Whenever there is a fault, any coil, that is trip coil, we generally call it as it, of the breaker gets energized and moving coil is pulled apart, thus the circuit is isolated. What are the types of circuit breakers? Miniature circuit breaker, MCB we call it as, you'll find mostly in almost every house, in every domestic appliance, domestic house. Earth leakage circuit breaker or residual current circuit breaker, ELCB or RCCB. Molded case circuit breaker, MCCB. Air blast circuit breaker, ACB. And vacuum circuit breaker, VCB. And SF6 circuit breaker. So these are the different types of circuit breakers. But in your syllabus, there are only MCB, ELCB and MCCB. You don't have this air blast circuit breaker, vacuum circuit breaker and SF6 circuit breaker. What is an MCB or miniature circuit breaker? These are electromechanical devices. These MCBs are electromechanical devices. They protect the equipment from overcurrents or over temperature. Overcurrent may be because of short circuit or overload, fault occurring in the system, etc. MCB is simply a switch which automatically turns off when there is a fault. What is the working principle? There are two contacts, as we have discussed, fixed and movable contacts. When current exceeds the limit, a solenoidal forces the movable contact to open. This is the principle. Therefore, MCB turns off. There are two coils, fixed and movable. Whenever there is a current or fault, then the current will exceed the limit and a solenoidal force forces the movable contact to open. And therefore, an MCB turns off. This is the cross-section of an MCB, miniature circuit breaker. These are the supply terminals. This is the frame, outside frame. This is the operating knob, which you move up and down. When it is in this up position, now the actually when it is in down, it is in off position. When you move it to up, it is on position. And if it is in the middle, it is in the trip condition. And there will be a bimetallic strip. These are the load terminals and these are the fixed contacts. And this is arc quenching knob. So this is a circuit breaker. If you can see, when it is under normal operating conditions, it is touching the blue color movable contact and there is a flow of current. When there is a fault, it will come like this and the contacts are open and the circuit breaker is tripped. Now, earth leakage circuit breaker. device used to directly detect current leaking through to earth from an installation and cut the power. This is earth leakage circuit breaker. That is the enclosures of any equipment. If there is an leakage, a human body can withstand up to a certain voltage and current. If it is beyond that, there will be a harm to the human being. So in order to detect that, if there is any leakage of current or voltage which is dangerous to human beings, that can be detected by this earth leakage circuit breaker, ELCB. There are two types of ELCBs, voltage ELCB and current ELCB. Voltage circuit breaker, current earth leakage circuit breaker. Now, what is voltage ELCB? It is a safety device used in electrical installations, but it is very rarely used nowadays due to some of its disadvantages. It is a voltage operated circuit breaker. VELCB contains a relay coil. One end of the coil is connected to metallic body and other end to the ground wire. The device will function when current passes through it. It detects small stray voltages on metallic enclosures of the equipment. Working of voltage earth leakage circuit breaker. If the voltage of equipment body or the core of any instrument rises, there could be a difference between earth and the load body voltage. And that means there is a chance of shock. This voltage difference will produce an electrical current which will pass through load metallic body and relay loop to the earth, and it disconnects. This is what happens when in an voltage ELCB, but sometimes due to and other reasons also this disconnection may happen. Therefore, this is very rarely used. This is voltage ELCB. As you can see, there are phase and neutral, that is the supply. This is the relay coil, and this is the connect to metal body part of any equipment. This is the metal body part. If you assume these are phase and load, phase and neutral of the load, and these are the This is connected to the ground. Whenever there is a difference of the voltage, this relay coil will operate and ELCB disconnects this device from the connection, supply connection. What is current ELCB? It's the most widely used earth leakage circuit breaker. It is a current operated circuit breaker, unlike the VELCB. It has three winding transformer. It has two primary winding and one secondary winding. Neutral and line wires act as primary, that is phase and neutral act as primary, and a wire wound coil is secondary. This is a current earth leakage circuit breaker. This is a test button. These are line and neutral supply. And this is load to any device that is connected to this, and this is the ground. This is grounded earth, and this is primary coil. This is the primary coil. This becomes the secondary coil, which is connected to a relay, which is directly connected to this operating switches. This is primary coil, as I told you. This is also primary coil. This is the load. Whenever if the supply is connected, the current that is flowing through this will flow along this, and it will reach this equipment, and it will also come out. The flux that is produced, because this is a coil, this is a toroid sort of thing, there is a flux that is generated in this, there is a flux that is generated also in this, and because of that they are in the opposite direction and they will cancel out. So there is no fault. Whenever there is no fault, the current that is flowing through this is equal to the current that is flowing through this neutral, same. But whenever there is a fault current, the current flowing through this and the current flowing through this will be different. That means the flux here and the flux here will be different. As a result, a flux flows in this circular path coil, and there is a flux that is created. The difference of the current is sensed by this, and this is called as, that is the reason this is called as the sensing coil, and it will activate the relay and switches are open. This is how an ELCB will work. It will disconnect this load from the supply whenever there is a difference of flux or currents in this, and this will happen whenever there is some current that is touching the core or the enclosure part of an equipment. Unless and until there is some current in the enclosures or the core of the equipments, nothing will happen. That is, this will continue to work normally. This is the operation of ELCB, current ELCB. When an error occurs, a slight current will run into the ground also. This creates a confusion between the line and the neutral current, as I told you, that makes an unstable magnetic field. Field will be unstable. This encourages a current flow through the minor winding, which is associated with the sensing circuit. This will detect the outflow and the direct signal to the tripping system. What is molded case circuit breaker, MCCB? MCCBs are electromechanical devices which protect circuit from overcurrent and short circuit faults. And the range of currents where it is used is 63 amperes to 3000 amperes. It generally has thermal element for overcurrent and magnetic element for short circuit detections. It does two things. One is overcurrent fault detection and short circuit. For overcurrent we have thermal element, and for short circuit we have magnetic element. MCCB has five major components. They are molded case or frame, and arc extinguishers, and contacts, and trip components operating mechanisms. These are the five components present in MCCB. They are manufactured such that the end user doesn't have to have access to internal parts of the circuit breaker. What is the construction of MCCB? Constructed of two pieces of heavy duty electrically insulated plastics. Two halves are riveted together to form whole part of the MCCB. Inside plastic there is a series of thermal elements and spring loaded trigger. When the thermal element grows warm, spring trips and circuit isolates. This is what happens generally. So it is constructed of two pieces of heavy duty electrically insulated plastics, and two halves are riveted together to form the whole equipment. Inside plastic there is a series of thermal element and spring loaded trigger, and when thermal element grows warm, spring trips and circuit isolates. Next, the operation of MCCB. At its core, the protection mechanism employed by MCCBs is based on the same physical principles used by all of the thermal magnetic circuits. The principle is same as the thermal magnetic circuits. The overload protection is accomplished by means of thermal mechanisms, as we have discussed. And MCCBs have bimetallic contact which expands and contracts in response to the changes in temperature. As you know, bimetallic strip will expand and contract according to the changes in the temperature. Under normal operating conditions, the contacts allow electrical current through MCCB. And if there is no fault, then the current will flow through the MCCB. As a current exceeds the adjusted trip value, the contact will start to heat and expand until the circuit is interrupted. Any overcurrent conditions that last more than what is normally expected represented on overload, and the MCCB is tripped to protect the equipment and personnel. On the other hand, fault protection is accomplished with electromagnetic induction and response is instant. Fault current should be interrupted immediately, no matter if their duration is short or long. Whenever a fault occurs, the extremely high current induces a magnetic field in the solenoidal coil located inside the circuit breaker. This magnetic induction trips a constant and current is interrupted. As a complemented to the magnetic protection mechanism, MCCBs have internal arc dissipation measures to facilitate interruption. Now this is the MCCB, molded coil circuit breaker, and this is the operating mechanism as you see, and this is a molded case frame. This is arc extinguisher, quenching, arc quenching mediums, and these are the contacts. This is a movable contact, and these are the terminal connections, and this is a trip bar. This is a simple cutaway of the circuit breaker, MCCB. Different types of MCCBs, you don't find this in your syllabus, but there are 5 types of MCCB: type B, type C, type D, type K, type Z. What are the applications of this MCCB? Due to the fact that they can handle especially high currents, molded case circuit breakers are often used with applications that are heavy duty. Some of them are as follows. Protecting generators. They usually produce hundreds of amperes in output and require expensive generator sets. MCCBs which can handle the high currents provide the protection needed. Protecting electrical feeders. They protect the feeders if there is any disturbance in the circuits. Welding machines. It is possible to have some welding application that draw very high currents, thus needing MCCBs since miniature circuit breakers cannot handle the high currents. Protecting capacitor banks. They are used to protect correct power factors in industrial, commercial, electrical systems, these capacitor banks. If the currents they draw are very high, MCCB's protection becomes necessary to reduce currents. Protecting motors. Electric motors also need to be adequately protected, and MCCBs do this work very well. Molded case circuit breakers do this very well because they need adequate protection. Inrush current may need to be adjusted, providing the necessary overload protection without tripping. Now, adjustable trip settings for the application with low currents is also one of the application. It is used in many of the cases. Now, if this is a general comparison between earth leakage circuit breaker and miniature circuit breaker. This is a practical ELCB and this is a miniature circuit breaker, MCB, and this is ELCB, current ELCB. And these are the different practical circuit breakers that are used. This is MCB, MCCB, ELCB, RCCB. RCCB is nothing but current leakage circuit breaker, actually it is. It's also a earth leakage circuit breaker, but this is a there are two types of earth leakage circuit breakers, right? The voltage and the current. So this is the part of that current earth leakage circuit breaker. Let's have some of the comparisons between MCB and MCCB. As you know, this definition, type of switch which protects the overloaded current, this protects the temperature and fault current. And miniature circuit breaker, molded case circuit breaker, tripping circuit is fixed in this and tripping circuit is movable in this. Available in single 2 and 3 versions, available in single 2, 3 and 4 versions. And interrupting rating capacity is 1800 amperes, it is 10k to 200k amperes. Remote on off is not possible in MCB, but it is possible in MCCB. And current rating, current is, this is the interrupting rating and this is the rating current. This is 100 amperes, this is 10 to 200 amperes. And in home wiring, applications are in home wiring, lightning circuits and low volts. It is in heavy current circuits and devices. For domestic purpose, this is used MCB, and for commercial and industrial purpose, MCCB is used. And this is the comparison between ELCB and RCCB. RCCB is residual current circuit breaker. Residual current circuit breaker. This is nothing but current operated device. This is a voltage operated device. As you know, ELCB is earth leakage circuit breaker. And this fault detection only detects earth faults that flow back from the main earth line. It will detect any earth fault. And connected to phase neutral as well as earth, it is only connected to phase and neutral, not the earth wire. Needs an earth connection itself, no need of earth connection. And these are the different types, AC, A and B. And nuisance tripping is less, and this is high and costly. This is very costly, ELCB, and RCCB is less costly and not recommended. Replace it with RCCB. Almost all wiring system use this RCCB nowadays. So RCCB is nothing but residual current circuit breaker. You can also write, if you are asked about RCCB, you can also start writing earth leakage circuit breaker. In earth leakage circuit breaker, there are two types. One is a voltage operated device, that is voltage earth leakage circuit breaker. Other one is current operated device, that is current earth leakage circuit breaker, which is also called as the residual current circuit breaker. This is the end of the lecture 13 and end of unit 5, basic electrical engineering. If you have any doubt, you can go back and watch the video once again. And today we have seen different types of circuit breakers. What is a circuit breaker? What is its mechanism? What are the different types of circuit breakers, their practical structures and the comparisons between them and their operations. We have seen what is MCB, MCCB, ELCB, and in ELCB there are two types, VELCB and current ELCB, which is also called as RCCB. So this is the end of lecture 13, basic electrical engineering. Thank you.